And let me play for you the chairman of the House Judiciary Committee, Jerry Nadler, who was on Meet the Press this morning talking about this very issue.
Do you think this is impeachable?
Yeah, I do. I do think that this, if proven, which hasn't been proven yet, some of this, if proven, some of this would be impeachable, yes.
All right.
Obstruction of justice, if proven, would be impeachable.
And you're going to go about to see if you can prove it?
Well, we're going to see where the facts lead us.
That is a very different demeanor than we saw during the Bill Clinton presidency, when people like Lindsey Graham, who was in the House at the time, and 13 other current United States senators on the Republican side not only wanted Bill Clinton to be impeached over lying about a sexual affair, but voted to convict him. What do you make of the fact that people who at the time said that obstruction of justice and getting witnesses to lie was impeachable are now silent on the Republican side?
Well, if you're referring to Lindsey Graham, you know that his word cannot be trusted. Remember when he used to be a friend of John McCain's? And remember when he turned on him? And so I don't know where he would go with this except to say he's now in bed with the president of the United States of America. And whatever he does now is about protecting this president no matter what he does. And so, you know, Lindsey does not have any real credibility, and I pay no attention to what he has to say. I think one of the things you have to think about is this. Who are the patriots? Who will stand up for America when our obvious enemy is basically hacking into our electoral systems? Who is going to stand up for America and claim to be a patriot when they see that there are many people around this president who have interacted with those from Russia, from the Kremlin, and with Putin? Where are they coming from? And I think when you ask yourself this question, you'd better be concerned about whether or not these are real patriots or whether or not they're in the pockets of the president of the United States wishing to gain favor from the president, and they're going to stand up for him no matter what. And so I call out their patriotism at this point in time. You take a look at this report, and you will be shocked at the information that's unfolding. I'm not shocked because, you know, I and my staff began to look very closely at this president early on. And when we looked at all of his allies and the people who were connected with him and with Putin and the Kremlin and with the oligarchs of Russia, we determined something was very wrong, and we dubbed them the Kremlin Klan. The Kremlin Klan, as identified, has been on my face page on Twitter for almost 2 years. We know who they are, and this report only confirms that. What more do we need to do? Okay, so if we cannot decide, if the Democrats cannot decide that they're going to move with impeachment, I guess they're going to go on with these investigations. How long are they going to go on with them? What more do they need to prove? I can only tell you, I, for one, have been for impeachment for a long time. I'm going to continue to be for impeachment. I think he should have been impeached a long time ago, and the American people are waiting on us to provide the leadership.
This is Financial Services Committee Chair Maxine Waters standing by her decision to be among the first Democrats to call for Trump's impeachment and taking a particularly strong stance against Lindsey Graham in the process. Graham is one of a number of Republicans who was quick to sanctimoniously grandstand about protecting the integrity of the office of the presidency, that even the slightest affront by a president was grounds for removal.
I have told you the best I can, there's no doubt these are high crimes, in my opinion. And this is a hard decision for our country, but when I first spoke to you, I thought we would be better off if Bill Clinton left office. And I want the chance to prove to you why. Give me a chance to prove to you why I believe that, why my colleagues voted our conscience to get this case to where it should be, not swept under a rug, but in a trial to a disposition. I have lost no sleep worrying about the fact that Bill Clinton may have to be removed from office because of his conduct. I have lost tons of sleep thinking he may get away with what he did.
So the point I'm trying to make is you don't even have to be convicted of a crime
to lose your job in this constitutional republic. If this body determines that your conduct as a public official is clearly out of bounds in your role, because impeachment is not about punishment. Impeachment is about cleansing the office.
Impeachment is about restoring honor and integrity to the office.
But surely if Graham and company were so intent on impeaching Clinton, whatever he did must have been worse than a slew of easily debunkable lies, nearly a dozen instances of obstruction of justice, and tacit approval of Russian meddling in our election, right? Yeah, he lied about having an affair. So while Lindsey Graham might have billed himself as this patriot, the fact is that when he finally had the opportunity to show that he'd be willing to buck the party and speak out against Trump's glaringly obvious corruption, he opted instead to defend his golf buddy. And here's the thing, Mueller outlined 10 instances where the president potentially obstructed justice and explicitly said that based on his findings, he wasn't able to exonerate the president. And this isn't absolving Clinton, but if a lie was apparently substantial enough to warrant impeachment in the 90s, then would any sane person on the face of the earth think that Trump should be exonerated? After firing James Comey, who was investigating him? After trying on multiple occasions to fire Mueller, who was investigating him? After trying to limit the scope of Mueller's investigation? After trying to get Don McGahn to lie for him to cover up his attempts to fire Mueller? After dangling pardons for Flynn and Manafort, who were cooperating with the special counsel? After his campaign took a meeting with a foreign adversary for dirt on a political opponent? And then, on top of all of that, the cardinal sin, according to Lindsey Graham, of lying about it? If you think Lindsey Graham in 1999 wouldn't have melted down into a puddle of holy water if Bill Clinton did 1/10 of the things that Trump has done, you're kidding yourself. I mean, Trump has told about 10,000 lies during his first 2 years in office, a number of which were literally about affairs. And yet, not a single word about cleansing the office from the senator from South Carolina. As Maxine Waters said, Republicans might think that they've laid claim to the word patriots, but their actions say the complete opposite. They're not loyal to the ideals of this country, to the Constitution or the law. They're loyal to their party, to Trump. That's it. Coddling a wannabe dictator isn't patriotic. It's the polar opposite of what our founders intended and the sole purpose for our system of checks and balances. But when one side decides to contract those powers back to the executive branch, I don't know that patriot is the first word that comes to mind.